Hi? Oh, there you are. Sorry, I was just testing the plugin.maui.audio, which now also has the ability to record audio. So let's check out how to implement that in your .NET MAUI app. Plugin.Maui.Audio package already allowed you to play sound files inside of your .NET MAUI application. Just install the NuGet, couple of lines of code, and you would be good to go to play all kinds of sound files from the click of a button or wherever you want to implement it. Now, since then, a lot, and I mean a lot of people have asked me, hey, can you also record sound with it? And that wasn't possible, but Sean, with who I'm working with on this project, my good friend Sean Lawrence, he has been working on this for a long time, and now it's finally implemented. You can also record sounds from your .NET MAUI application with this plugin.maui.audio package. So let's check out how to do that. Moving over to my screen share, I created a new .NET MAUI project here in Visual Studio 2022. It goes without saying, you can also do this from VS Code, on your Mac, whatever you prefer, but I'm doing it from Windows for today. And this is just the default template. I already got a couple of things set up, but I will walk you through that, no worries. And from there, we will start implementing the code. So let's go over to our Solution Explorer, right-click on your project and do Manage NuGet Packages. And here under Browse, you want to search for plugin.maui.audio. You should check the include pre-releases at the time of recording. It is released as a pre-release version 2.0.0 preview 2. That's the one that you want to have at a minimum if you want to use the recording functionality. By the time that you're watching this, it might already be out and stable, but this is the minimum version that you will need. So install that, click on the little install button here, and it should be installed on your project. Then from there, you want to also do the permissions. Now, this is all explained on the plugin repository. So if you get confused, I will link the repository down below. Don't worry, go check that out. But here in the manifests and that kind of stuff, you want to go over to your project platforms. And then for Android, you have the Android manifest. For iOS and Mac Catalyst, you have the info plist right here. And then for Windows, we have the package appx manifest as well. So I'm just going to show you the ones for Android and iOS. You can figure the Windows one out yourself. I'm pretty sure of that. But here we have this info plist, which is for iOS, and this is the exact same thing for Mac Catalyst, but just in a different file. So make sure to do them both if that's the platforms that you're targeting. You want to do this key right here to use the microphone and give it a little description. iOS will show a description to the user with a little explanation that you fill in here with why you want to have microphone access. So make sure that you put something valid in here that users will be like, oh yeah, this makes sense for this app. I'm going to allow that. For Android, same thing, but you need a couple of extra permissions. Record audio, modify audio settings, and read and write external storage, because we are actually writing a audio file, right? Which is actually a good cue. So recording format is not something that we can set right now. It's all recorded, I think, in kind of like a, I'm not an expert on recording audio formats, but I think we do it in WAV format or PCM, and I think that all is kind of ties together. So it's in WAV format for all the platforms because that's what they support. That's because the why the file format can be a little bit bigger, but you know, maybe in some next version, we will be able to allow the file format to be different, right? I'm not sure what's supported on all the platforms, but maybe that's something that we can think about. Let me know on the repository if that's something that's important to you. Okay, we got that set up. Then in our main page, actually, we don't have to set up anything visually. I'm just going to reuse what's here. So this will just be the waving.net bot, right? We'll see that in a minute. And I'm just going to reuse the counter button right here to actually start recording if it is recording and stop the recording and play back the audio if we actually have recorded something. So I'm just going to go to the code behind right here. And before we do all this, we want to do it the right way. Like there with all the plugins, we follow kind of like the same pattern as the .NET MAUI Essentials APIs. You can do it in two ways. So you can actually register it for dependency injection and do it like that, which is the proper way. That's probably what you want to do. Or you can use the static instance and just use it that way. I'm going to show you dependency injection right now, and also going to, for the playing the audio, I'll just show you the static implementation. So we'll see both flavors right here. So let's go over to the Solution Explorer and go to my MAUI program. And here I can register everything for dependency injection. So here I can say builder.services. Dot add singleton, because our audio service can be a singleton. Doesn't really have any state or that kind of stuff, but you can still register it as a singleton. And what you want to do is say audio manager, which is a type of the audio plugin, dot current. That is our property for the current implementation. Now, you want to make sure to include the using plugin dot Maui dot audio here at the top, and then it will start recognizing that audio manager and the current property that comes with it. Now, if we want to use that to inject it into our main page, we also need to register our main page. So let's do builder dot services dot add transient, which makes more sense for pages. And we want to do the main page right here. Okay, so we got that set up. We're now ready to go with the dependency injection. That's all you need to do in .NET MAUI. And now I can just go over to my main page.xaml.cs. And here in my constructor, it's already selected in the right place. I can say, hey, I audio manager, because we also use interfaces. So you could swap out implementations if that's what you want for testing purposes or whatnot. So we can use this I audio manager. It will automatically pick that up, even though we register the actual implementation here, but it will know to use that I manager and it will still resolve it, right? So we can do that. And I'm going to use I audio manager here. Then create a little field for it. Let's make that read only because we're not going to change it. I audio manager, so we can use that. And of course, all this code can be found in a sample repo, which you can find the link down below. So if you want to review the code, you totally can. And what I also want to do is have an I audio recorder, because we have a special recorder here as well. So we registered that. Now, whenever we get here, I can say audio manager is audio manager that gets injected through dependency injection. And then from that audio manager, I can say audio recorder is audio manager dot create recorder. I have to create this recorder, right? So it's going to create the right things. It's going to initialize it for you, and you can actually start recording with that. We got that in place. We have the audio manager. The audio manager creates a recorder, and we have everything set up to actually do the recording. So in this counter clicked, this is just a button. If you click it, we're going to actually not use all of this. So I'm going to remove it, and we're going to check if we're actually recording, yes or no, and then we're going to actually play it back. Of course, your implementation is going to probably be a little bit more extensive, but for now, this will get the point across to help you get started with all of this. So what we want to do first is check the permissions, right? We still need to get the actual permissions from the user to be able to access the microphone. And luckily, .NET MAUI has stuff for that built in. So we can just say if, and I think we need to do await here, permissions. So we have the permissions APIs. Dot request async, and you can here do permissions dot microphone, and the microphone should be enough, even though Android has a couple of extra things, but you should be able to just do this for the microphone, and that should be enough. Not is, because we get a status back here, permission status, and if it's not granted, then we're going to return, right? We're going to just return. You probably want to do inform your user, because how it typically works, whenever a user denies this once, then they have to go through the app settings and whatnot to actually re-enable the permission. So you want to inform your user to go through all that and maybe detect and gracefully fall back in your application. So there we have that, but we're going to go to HEPA path. So we are just going to have this granted and go from there. You can see it added the async here automatically, so that's needed. Async void is not great. Make sure to wrap this in a try catch to catch the actual exceptions that might arise from this, but this is just because, you know, these event handlers have to be void, but they can be async. Whole different topic. Let me know if that's something that you want to learn more on down in the comments. Then we can check this audio recorder, if it is recording. Is recording, yes or no? And if it's not, we're going to start the recording. So we're going to say audio recorder dot start async. Again, async thing. So you might want to await this. And we have a couple of overloads. If you don't specify any parameters, it's going to generate a random file at the default location of the device, temporary file, basically, and it's going to start recording from there. You will get to that audio and the contents whenever we stop it. I'll show you that in a little bit. Or you can provide your own path and file name right here, and it will start recording in a file there. So options for you to use. From there, If we stop the recording, so else, if we are recording and it's going to get here, then we have this stop async. It already suggests this to me, so let's just do that. But what you want to do here is actually you'll get back a audio source, an iAudio source. So we are going to use that. I recorded audio is this. So now we have captured that in this variable right here. And let's inspect what we have there. And there's actually just one interesting thing, which is get audio stream. So you can get the stream from that audio, which is the contents of that file. And that we can use to automatically start playing that back to the user again whenever we stop it. And here I'm going to show you like the static usage of this API. So I could also definitely use dependency injection, or I don't even need to use dependency injection. I could just create a new audio player here, and I could say audio manager dot create player, see, it's right here, or create async player if you want to play async things. Highly recommend that you check out my other video, which should pop up on your screen right now, about playing the audio. I have a full video on that as well. But this one is about recording. But you, so you could instantiate it that way, or you can just do audio manager dot current dot create player. And we have this audio player. So let's create this player. And then what we can do, I think we have to specify the stream immediately. So you can just say recorded audio dot get audio stream, and we get the stream back from this, and we can play it from right here. Now the player has a couple of more APIs. Again, we're not really interested because we're exploring the recording right here, but we can just say, hey, play with this thing, and we can now play back the audio. So I'm going to deploy this to my physical Android device that I have lying right here, and I mirrored the screen to this app right here. And the application should come up in a little bit where it's going to be deployed. I think I have the volume up. Well, let's set it all the way up. I hope I'm not going to go deaf with my own voice here. We should see the default .NET MAUI template, which is not, you know, super impressive. But typically, if you click the button, then it's going to increment. Now it's going to start the recording, and it should ask me for the permission. So let's click it, and you can see it asked me for the permission because that's what I implemented. Of course, the user has all these options. I'm just going to do only this time, and then whenever I keep continue talking, it's just going to record my voice, and when I stop the button, you're going to hear this again repeated. And then whenever I keep continue talking, it's just going to record my voice. And when I stop the button, you're going to hear this again repeated. See? So that's how it actually works. You can record audio now with this plugin inside of your .NET MAUI application with just a couple of lines of code. And that is how easy it is. Now, obviously, this also works on iOS, macOS, Windows. You saw all the platforms that we can specify the permissions for. So we got all that. I think there's definitely some room to expand the API. So please let me know down in the comments if you have any questions. Maybe feature requests are better to go to the plugin repository. So the link can be found below. Go there and please put in your feature requests. And of course, if you want to know more about playing that audio, check out this video right here. And now, if you'll excuse me, I did it my way.